Okay. And she was putting stuff together. I said, okay, this will be the only time it'll be this way. I said, it'll be different next year. And this year, it was kind of tough. We were talking earlier about how, you know, I mean, you never know how many people are going to come to a thing. But during COVID, you really have no clue. But we've got a special little time scheduled tonight, I think. A little quiet time and just some time to reflect. And I want to kind of give you some guidelines on it in a few minutes. But the first thing, you want to make sure you can see the screen. We're going to join together in singing, Were You There? So first I want to read for us the story of the Last Supper in the Gospel of Matthew. Then one of the 12, whose name was Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What will you give me if I deliver him over to you?" And they paid him 30 pieces of silver. And from that moment he sought an opportunity to betray him. Now on the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus saying, "Where will you have us prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He said to them, "Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.' And the disciples did as Jesus had directed them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he reclined at table with the 12, and as they were eating, he said, 'Truly I say to you, one of you will betray me.' They were very sorrowful. And began to say to him one after another, 'Is it I, Lord?' He answered, 'He who has dipped his hand in the dish with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born.' Judas, who would betray him, answered, 'Is it I, Rabbi?' Jesus said to him, 'You have said so.' Now as they were eating, Jesus took bread and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body.' And he took a cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them saying, 'Drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink it again of this fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.' So that's why we're here tonight, to reenact a little bit, to remember together, to celebrate together that Thursday night when they had their Last Supper. And nobody gathering there expected it to be changed. Nobody expected it to become something different than what it is. They just were there for Passover, as they always did. But that night, everything changed when Jesus came and put new words into the ceremony. Tonight, as we celebrate communion, I want to share with you kind of how we're going to do it. And I didn't really count, so we'll have to see how it works when we have the people. But we are going to leave here, and in a group, if there's 12 people total, that's what I'm hoping for, is if we have 11, 12 counting Maryland, but I don't want any more than 12, so we may divide up smaller. But I'm going to have our servers go up front, and then I'll have you go up. I'll tell you when. There's some music to go with this, and I want you to share and listen and read the words and spend some time with the music reflecting. But I'll have you go up to the very front row of the sanctuary, and up there you will be served communion. And then afterwards, I want you to, they'll send you around, and you go back about three or four pews, and there's some pews that have some little cards in them. And in the cards, each card has a pen, so you can write, and each card has a thing, and then there's a little note, and I want to share the note with you now, so I'm not going to read the whole thing, but so you know what it is. We're going to take these cards, and I'm going to have you write on them, and then a little later in the service, we're going to present them at the cross. Okay, and so what you're putting on here are, and it doesn't have to be written like as a letter. You can if you want to, but it can just be like a little list. Three things: something for which you've been forgiven by God, something that he has changed in you, and then something that he has promised for you. And the little paper there, you can look it over when you get there. It explains it, even has an example for you. Nobody's going to see it. When you're done writing, put it in the envelope and seal the envelope. And then we'll have a moment when I'll give you instructions at that point. So with that, we're going to move into our time of communion. And before we do, let me have a bit of a blessing for that. Lord, as we come before you at the table, we're mindful that this is a remembrance of that first time when you gathered the disciples, when you came to that moment when everything was about to change, and you spent that time with them earnestly. You said you desired to do that. So, Lord, we have gathered earnestly wanting to spend this time with you, especially this year when, after all the COVID things and how things were last year, we didn't get to do some of the things. So, Lord, it's great to be back together. Lord, we ask you to meet us at the table tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. So you can watch the screen. Some of the songs, if they have words, if you want to sing along, you're welcome to do that. Okay.
From wherever you've been, come brokenhearted, let rescue begin. Come find your mercy, oh sinner, come kneel. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. So lay down your burden. Thank you. hope for the hopeless and all those who've strayed. Come sit at the table, come taste the grace. There's rest for the weary, rest that endures. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't cure. So lay down your
sacrifice. Let my life give you cry, worthy is the Lamb of God. We cry, worthy. We cry, worthy. We cry, worthy is the Lamb of God. We cry.
When they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all fall away because of me this night. For it's written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I'm raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." Peter answered him, "Though they all fall away because of you, I will never fall away." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times." Peter said to him, "Even if I have to die with you, I will not deny you." And all the disciples said the same. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." And taking with them Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful, troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me." And going a little further, he fell on his face and he prayed, saying, "My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." And he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. He said to Peter, "So could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again, for the second time, he went away and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words again. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Sleep and take your rest later on. See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. My betrayer is at hand." We've been reading out of John through Lent, and I want to remind you how the words were written on Maundy, Thursday in John's Gospel, just a little bit. Now, before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart out of this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. So we celebrate this supper, and at that moment, Jesus knew his hour had come. He knew what the road was ahead. He knew Peter would betray him. He knew Judas would betray him. Peter would deny him. He knew he'd be tried. He knew he'd be crucified. He knew the disciples would all run away. And knowing those things, he loved them to the end. So these little cards that you've got, we've got some music, some nice reflective music, got some good words in some of it for you to read. Some of it is stuff that you might already know. But think about some of these things. These are the ways that we maybe have denied him. Or some of the things you may end up writing down are some of the ways that he's loved you to the end. Some of the things may be the ways he's challenging you to know your hour has come for whatever the next stage of growth is or challenge in your life. We are going to just take a few minutes, and here's how it's going to work. We're going to listen to some of the music, reflect on what you've written, maybe the cross, maybe the words, time in prayer. You know, afterwards they went out singing a hymn. We're going to end with a song that we sing together. But Jesus went out and they prayed in the garden. So this is a prayer time. And at a certain point in the process, I'll have my card done. I haven't done mine yet. And I'll come, and we want to lay them at the foot of the cross. Like I said, nobody else is going to see these. Seal the envelope. They're going to disappear after the service tonight. It's between you and the Lord. But that's going to be one of our pieces tonight. And for those of you that came late, when you come up, I'll be up here, and you can take communion at that point as well when you come up. And then go return here to your seats, and then we'll have a song that we close with. Okay, so enjoy the music. Enjoy the prayer time. encourage you to go on to the next song. As she plays, now's the time to bring up your envelopes as you like. If you'd like to pause to have a prayer, there's plenty of time with the song. Return to your seats afterwards. And then I'll watch for when you guys come up, and I'll have communion off to the side here for you guys. Okay.
Thought of me
it's kind of Michael W. Smith night. I just had several of the songs that I really like tonight wanted to share. I want to have Nola play that one again for us, and I want to have you stand. We're going to, if you don't know it, that's why I let it run. Maybe it'll help you know it. We're going to sing that one. It's kind of our closing song. As they went out, then everything began. The world changed in the next 20 hours, and it changed for the better. And it changed for you, and it changed for me. Because like the song said, he was thinking of us. I would remind you the little booklets have at the front. There's the times for all the different services, and there's actually the order of service and stuff. If you want to know what's going to happen to the different ones, we still have Good Friday and Sunrise and Pancakes and Easter. I don't think the times for Easter are in there, but, you know, it's regular services. So why don't you stand with me? Let's sing together as best you can. No, and if not, just listen to it. And this will be our closing song. No, I'll turn it up just a little bit for this one.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Yeah.
we thank you that you think of us. Small though we may be, and one individual among billions on the earth, but you think of us. And you took the fall for us, that we could come before you in glory one day. Lord, in this season of the year, we're especially mindful of what you've done for us. May we be reminded, may we be enriched, open our minds to something more as we behold afresh your suffering, your sacrifice, and your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. As you leave, I want to ask you to, if you want to visit, to wait till you're outside the sanctuary, because some people may want to linger here. We invite you to do that if you'd like to, and some prayer time. You're welcome to stay however long you would like to. And God bless you. Thank you so much for coming tonight.